Dan kuasa XYZ akong dia mesti dah akong dong deh. Ada apa yang akan kamu ni? Okay lah.
Numbers 18 verse 24.
Yes.
But the tithes of the children of Israel, which they offer as a leave offering unto God. So I have given to the Levites.
So you see, only Levites. You forget one thing that, and in that we're talking about money.
Right.
Talk about one thing that clothes, one thing that food. Because the Levites, they only one way, so
officiate
in the tabernacle. So then you say, then there is a word, there's a need, the tabernacle. So then you get one thing that everything come in. You understand? Now them, now these religious leaders and teachers, now them, they become one time rich out of mankind. Mm-hmm. Everything, everything I'm going to pay them for was. You understand? They say, I'll pay a tithe and offering. You don't pay nothing. A young man, you're supposed to pay the creator in this age now.
Divided.
I have divided attention.
And
divided. Undivided attention. Mm-hmm. You understand? That's why you're supposed to pay the creator now, your undivided attention. Mm-hmm. You understand? When the creator of that, you're supposed to pay attention to him. You understand? And if not, you can't say, you don't need fire. You need fire. You can say, if I want, I won't tell you. You understand? You say, I care about it, a thousand belongs to me. All the gold and the rooms and the hire, we think it belongs to you. It belongs to Yahweh, right? So you think it's Yahweh, I want your junior and that. But the dinner is that slide, right? That was sliding. So you know, the creator doesn't want that about slide. You see? If you know, try to say Yahweh, it's a US dollar, it's not a disrespect, I disrespect the creator, see? You try to say Yahweh, it's a euro dollar, it's still a disrespect. You can't buy salvation. Salvation is a free gift. You understand? Free of cost.
Revelation 13:17. Okay. That no man had died or said, okay. Save you that has a mark on the middle of the beast of the number of his days.
So this is
where is wisdom.
This is what I'm saying. So here is wisdom. No,
let him that has understanding,
yeah,
come to the number of the beast.
We just come a while ago.
For it was the number of a man.
It is the number of a man.
And his number, yeah, is six. Revelation 13 verse 18.
Really?
600.
Three score.
And six.
So right away, if you now have, you now have Yahweh, Elohim, and Yahshua, you know your forehead, you know what I'm saying? Yes. Or in your spirit, and you find yourself with all of these idols. This is why you have 666. I walk wrong with it. And if my feet say, you have something. But you have in your house. It's a little mess. Going on to the lake with it. I just say, we're that many tickets. We just say, we're going to take it to the lake. Yes.
Revelation 18, verse 4.
Okay.
And I heard another voice from him.
Yes. Say,
come out of her, my people.
Come more of them, my people. Come out of them church and states.
That he be not partakers of her sin.
You might not partake of your sins.
And that he receive not of her plagues.
And they receive that. None of our plagues. Okay. Now, you can do some correction, right? I'm going to run with it.
It's verse 3:13.
Yes.
And Moses said unto Elohim.
Now, we have the true divine name, the creator. And the true divine name. He said, Moses, Elohim, read.
Behold, when I come unto the children of Israel, and shall say unto them,
yeah,
the Elohim of your fathers has sent me unto you, they shall say to me, what is his name?
So we are your
what
true.
What shall I say unto them?
We are your true. Curious, the title, the creator chose for him, but Yahweh chose for himself. No, because Elohim is a title. You understand? Not a name. You can say, this is Yahweh in English. This is Elohim in English. This is Yahshua in English. This is Yahweh in Hebrew. Elohim in Hebrew. Yahshua in Hebrew. This is Yad E Wa E. This is Hebrew. You understand? And the final, so the Hebrew man write it. It read from right to left. English read from left to right. You understand? So Yad. A Yad. Yad, a Y sound. A H Y W. Another A H. Now Hebrew is a continental language. You understand? But the Hebrew man speak there, insert your vowel, you understand? Now we know we need the aid of written vowel to make our word. Because this is the Hebrew tetragrammaton. This is English tetragrammaton. Tetra means four, and grammaton means letters. So you have Y, H, W, H, you understand? So we were instructed by this great divine vision of revelation to go to the first man, but Yahweh heard, and insert You're involved with him. Why aren't you? From the masculine portion of the name, which is Yah. So you say on your head, that's Yah. Go to the only one of Yah group and farm. The only vowel between the W and the H. Farm way. So Yahweh is both masculine and feminine in principle within himself. You understand? So write it in Yahweh, Madam Bride. You understand? In him. Now if you open love, it's not masculine gender. Do you know how you feel the form of art? You check God, that's the same thing. Masculine, no female counterpart. Jesus Christ, masculine, no female counterpart. But yeah, right in Yahweh, it was male and female. And for sure, that is Yahweh, the one who created the creation. If you check plant kingdom, animal kingdom, they are both male and female. You check first, you check herb, ganja. You have the male herb and the female herb. Okay? That's plant. Mama try the same thing. Guinea try the same thing. You have male guinea and female guinea. You understand? Coming down right through. That's why you got some countries, some big guinea tree. And I said, oh, it's a guinea tree, I'm my grandpa. He said, man, I'm a man guinea that man. Chop out, chop down, go. You understand? So it's so all of these. All of these, and all of these. You know, yeah, where you go? Chop them down, go. You understand? See? So when we say these now, I talk about what you have in your heart and mind. Like you have demon in your heart and mind. That's what you have in your video. You understand? They can say, these now, no. This is canvas, no. But we are dealing with what you have in your heart and mind and what I'm with. You understand? So if you have these and what I'm running with your heart and mind, it's your sweet to see it, not these. No, no, they're not going to be here. They're not ready. You see, yeah, we're going to chop it down.
I'm going to call.
I'm going to call.
That's what I'm going to say.
Leviticus chapter 20, verse 13.
Yeah.
If a man also lie with mankind.
So if a man lie with mankind now.
As he lies with a woman.
As he lies with a woman.
Both of them have committed an abomination.
Yeah, this is of Yahweh. It's the abomination.
They shall surely be put to death.
So Yahweh will put them, chop them down.
Put them to death. Shall be up on them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you see, we have it for sure. Yahweh, queen has that problem with him. You understand? Male and female. You understand? That's Yahweh, and Yahshua. He's Shua. You understand? That's why I mean, everybody says, you have three up here recording the thing. John 5 and 7, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Spirit. He's Shua. Yahweh is not a Trinity. Yahweh is a unity. That's why the first commandment was here. You're all Israel. Yahweh, thy Elohim is Yahweh, a unity. This is truth, you understand? It's not a creator. Who is Yahweh? This is the devil. It's a devil playground. You understand? You're a devil creating this. So if you want to make friend with the devil, you can't call what he is. If you want to make friend with the devil. But we are devil and friend. We can't cast him out of mankind. And I'm going to show myself. I'm going to show you. Okay, that.
Exodus 3:14, and Elohim said unto Moses, I am Asher, I am.
I am. Not I am, but I am. The true framework of God, I am Asher, I am. That means Yahweh saying, he will to be whatsoever he will to be, he will to say whatsever he will to say, he will to do whatsever he will to do. You check Yahweh, he's a all in all. You understand? No, I am that I am. I am that I am is limited. But Yahweh is I am Asher, I am. Don't forget one day.
Verse 15, and Elohim said
moreover
unto Moses.
So Elohim speaking unto Moses,
thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel.
Is it where he said children of Israel, not the children of England, or Assyria, or German, children of Israel?
Yahweh.
Yahweh.
The Elohim of your fathers. Is the Elohim of Abraham. Elohim of Abraham. Elohim of Isaac. Elohim of Jacob. Elohim of Jacob.
Elohim of Jacob. Elohim of Jacob. Elohim of Jacob. Elohim of
Jacob. This
is my name forever, this is my memorial to all generations. He said, this is my name forever, and this is my memorial to all generations. So the new Yahweh is from eternity to eternity. And it is forever. You see?
Exodus 6 and 2, when Elohim spake unto Moses and said unto him,
so,
I am Yahweh.
I am Yahweh.
And I appeared unto Abram, unto Isaac, and unto Jacob, by the name of El Shaddai, by title, but by my name Yahweh was I not known unto
you. So you have appeared unto Peter by El Shaddai, which means Almighty Provider. When you say by his name Yahweh, you never have been known to them. But the first man he met, he didn't know unto what was. When they meet me, yeah, Moses' name to his Israelite down in Egypt. I see Moses, making known unto Moses. But back there is a call in El Shaddai. You see? But that means that Yahweh was in there, so Yahweh must have been in there, still. Okay, that.
Psalm 68 and 4. Sing unto Elohim.
Says, sing unto Elohim. Elohim is purely the title of the Creator for himself now. Not a man can come in. That is the common title. Assyria. No doubt. Sing unto Elohim.
Sing praises to his name.
Praise unto Elohim's name.
Extolling the right upon the heavens by his name, Yah.
Extolling the right upon your heavens by his name. No, we're not talking about the sky or the space or the right about you. Everything written unto you right in the concept. This is ever right here. You write upon your heaven, the concept. That's where Yahweh is right within you. Oh, you know that. Check your bread of life. Check your bread of life. And see what it says here. This is your bread of life. Psalm
115. Let everything that has breath.
No, Yahweh is
praise Yahweh.
He said, let everything that has breath praise Yahweh. So you have breath. That's Yahweh in you, are praise himself. Even the dog have breath and praise Yahweh. Are you ready? Read that, young dog, I run. I will praise and run down, and up. And run down. Mark me, he doesn't come in. I praise Yahweh. Cancer is the breath of life. Even the hands have breath of life in him. And breathe Yahweh. The tree, go there. Praise Yahweh. And like the book, Yahweh says, every prospect pleases him. Every prospect pleases him. The bird. If you listen to the bird over there, you want to burn him, you can judge him. Yahweh! Yahweh! Call by Yahweh. The donkey. Listen to the donkey over here. Yahweh! It's only the donkey of me. I call by Yahweh. You understand? He had Billy. You can cry like a girl, like that still. You can cry like a girl. But you little baby. Because the doctor wear a baby and spank it from behind, he take the breath of life and stop. Yahweh! Yahweh! And stop calling Yahweh. You see himself? So Yahweh said, every prospect pleases him. On the mankind, disobedient. Because when the mankind come and realize why Yahweh, they must talk. They can't say call anything you want, call him. If we understand, if we understand, Yahweh and one understand, say disobedient.
Isaiah 50:10.
Who is among you that feareth Yahweh? Do you fear him? Because if you fear him, you are, you reverent him.
That obeyeth the voice of his servant.
That you obey his voice.
That walketh in darkness and hath no light.
If you walk in darkness, these are the darkness, you know. And there is no light in them. Because this coming like the moon. Because the moon and the light itself, you know. It's like the light of the sun. So this is like the moon. Because the light is fair, I get from Yahshua. That's a matter of hear some Christian people that they say, yeah man, Jesus and Yahshua, I see the man lying. No. Yahshua is not a Babylon water god. This is a Babylon water god. A mermaid. A fish. You understand? That's how it. Not the word I love, the fish thing so much, because this guy is just a fish. You know what I'm saying?
The Isaiah 50:10 continues. Let him trust in the name of Yahweh.
So we, you know, go on here, we trust in the name of our Heavenly Father, Yahweh, Elohim, Yeshua.
And stay upon his Elohim.
That's what we trust in. We continually meditate upon our Elohim.
That's it.
You understand? We don't leave Yahweh, you know. We don't leave Yahweh. Because we know, say, we don't need nobody from Brad to come to us and say, true. We know, say, true. Amen.
Matthew 1:21.
Yeah.
And she shall bring forth a son.
So this is Miriam. They say, back there, them say, that's Mary, Maria, Mermian. That's why you know, Jesus is a fish. He said, Maria, I'm mother. You understand? Which is a fish, or a Mermian. He said, let her.
And she shall bring forth a son.
So he said, Miriam now shall bring forth a son.
And thou shalt call his name Yahshua.
And thou shalt call his name Yahshua.
For he shall save his people from their sins.
For his purpose coming to the world was to save mankind from their sin, or his people from their sin. You understand? So you come in and if you look, you say Yahshua, he shall save. Shua in Hebrew tongue is salvation. Or as I mean salvation, but our showing you was in salvation. So right in Yahshua, there is salvation. Now if them say Jesus was the Savior now, you know the name Jesus. So per. Because this is Greek, it's a Greek word. I'm telling you for me, Zeus. So you know the name Jesus Sauter. But you call Jesus Christ. So there is no salvation right here. But you want salvation? So you want Yahshua. Shua in Hebrew studies his salvation. So write in the name of Yahshua your salvation, your soul.
John 5:43.
I
am coming my father's name,
but
he received me not.
Well, Yahshua means I always want speaking. Say, I've come in my father's name.
And he received me not.
But you never received me.
Let another come in his own name, if you will receive.
No, Yahshua tell you what's going on. He said, let another come in his own name. If you will receive. So right away now, this guy is nobody named Jesus Christ. Come in one name. Or you can't even know them come in one name. If they say Lord and Father, they don't belong to God. If they say God and Mother, they don't belong to God. You understand? You come in one name, come as Jesus Christ. So you will receive a nobody come in one name. And this guy is a bastard. And he said, you're no bastard in the kingdom. No bastard in the kingdom. You must have a name. You understand? That's everything in our creation, our name. Everything in the creation must have a name. Every tree. No matter if plant or the plant, every plant have a name. Alright, what is it now? Suppose you don't go to the supermarket and you have to buy something. And when you go to the supermarket, everything is
labelless.
Thank you. Everything is labelless. How you work it out? You need a name. I mean, a name is very important. Just like your name is very important. You understand? That's why a man can't trap you. Very much can't trap you. You understand? If I look funny now, using word called Barcelona. If them, well, many language them speaking, but if them speak like, young boy, and you say, you're a bullet, how about that? You can't have your name. Your name is important. Your name is the identity. So everything, every way, touch name, very, very important. Okay, that's good. Right?
Be it known unto you all and to all the people of Israel.
All the people now we are bringing them to Jamaica. All the people of Jamaica.
That by the name of Yahshua the Messiah of Nazareth whom you crucified.
So then crucify Yahshua the Messiah afresh. Because you should call him what I mean and you crucify him afresh. Whom you crucify afresh.
Whom Yahweh raised from the dead.
Whom Yahweh raised from the dead. Because say Yahshua is the one who come down. He's the one who died. He's the one who buried. And he's the one who resurrected, and that's the gospel. He preached his own gospel. So he got to a death, he got to a burial, and he rose again, victoriously. Whom he crucified.
Whom Yahweh raised from the dead.
Whom Yahweh raised from the dead.
Even by him does this man stand before you whole. Even, this is the stone which was set at naught of you builders, which has become the head of the corner.
So Yahshua has been the head corner stone.
Neither is there salvation in any other.
He said, neither is there sure, because you're not sure in any other. Neither is there sure in any other.
For there's none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved.
Mm-hmm. Where mankind must be saved. You must be saved by this name, Yahshua Messiah. This is a saving name. This is a soul name. So if you have this name, your soul, you ain't gonna have no salvation. You understand? What do you have? Yes.
Wherefore, Yahweh also
highly
exalted him.
So Yahweh highly exalted Yahshua the Messiah.
And giving him a name.
Not 72 name, but a name.
Which is above every name.
Which is above every name.
That at the name of Yahshua the Messiah.
At the name of Yahshua the Messiah.
Every knee should bow.
Every knee. Not talking about something right here. right here, head cover, in genuines. Your knee must bow. That means your bow right here. Your bow, yeah. I see that. You see, right here, genuines. Your bow, yeah, I see that. Your knee must bow.
Of things in heaven and things in earth,
things
and
in
things
heaven,
under the earth.
Things in earth,
and
things
that
under
every
earth.
Tongue should confess that Yahshua the Messiah is the Savior to the glory of Yahweh the Father.
You have a bow here and you have confess in the tongue. Say, Yahshua is the Savior to the glory of Yahweh. My hand is there, you confess now. No matter what you confess, I have confessed it. But you must confess. Say, you bet you confess now. And see Yahshua in your heavens right now. More when you're in your lake, you realize, yes, man, Yahshua! But I'm going to say, yes, Yahshua. You understand? So you better confess now and come to Yahshua. Okay.
Revelation 14:1.
Right.
And I looked, and lo, a lamb stood on Mount Zion.
Yes.
And with him 144,000 having his name and his father's name written in their forehead.
Forehead, meaning front of the field. So that's a forehead, it's a word, the forehead. So you have the name on you, and in you. So what's your name and you? You have two eyebrows, one come this way, one come this way. The nose come down, perfect little wife. They have, what you kept there, A, bridge across, that's A. You have two, you have a cut, bottom level and two last line, that's H. And what's your W? So you have the W. You have the W. And what's this now? You have the E, you have the A. Because Eve was taken out of Adam. So you have the E right in the A. Like an epsilon. So you have this E. And some right in the name. She. E. So you have the E right in the A. And that's when you have the two ribs. Because there's two H's. So right now it doesn't say that there's a Yahweh. Does Yahweh recognize every man? But Yahweh is supposed to already. The greatest thing, you write it in you also. You understand? You can't say, he say Yahshua in you is all over glory. So you want it written in you. You can say Yahshua in you is your own over glory. So you want to have Yahshua in you written. Okay, that. We better wait until time is there, right? No, so the gospel is the debt. The burial and the resurrection of Yahshua. 1 Corinthians 15, 1 to 4. You understand? Now, so you see by the name and the preaching of the gospel. You understand? That's why Jonah, he was sent to Nineveh, to one of Nineveh, right? He took a ship to Tarshish. You understand? And so you find said, Yahweh sent a great storm after that guy Jonah became disobedient. You understand? And he went to the bottom of the ship to have a sleep. The mariner, the storm of the ship to and fro, and start throw up the thing about the ship and thing. And they find Jonah sleeping. And so, wake up, man, wake up, why are Jonah sleeping? And this great temptation is upon us. And he can't tell, say, he was running away from Yahweh. You understand? And he tells him, take him up and throw him away, across the, and the sea will come out of there. So, they took him up and threw him away from the sea. And, you understand? You have to cut it. Yeah, man. So Jonah preached the gospel. Ananias, Azariah, missionary preached the gospel. So, they can't say, the God is an everlasting gospel. That's what we have when you write the name, an everlasting gospel. The gospel is preached from heaven to earth. You understand? So they said this gospel can't preach, can't done. It's an eternal gospel. And this is the gospel of Yahshua Messiah. Read.
1 Corinthians 15:1.
Yeah.
Moreover, brethren, I declare unto you the gospel.
The gospel.
Which I preach unto you.
So we preach the good tidings and the good tidings.
Which also you have received.
So you're supposed to receive it.
And wherein you stand.
You're supposed to stand in the preaching of the gospel.
By which also you are saved.
And you see the greatest thing about it, you're saved by the preaching of the gospel.
If you keep in memory what I preach unto you.
And you must keep it in memory. What preach unto you or what Yahshua said to you.
Unless you have believed in vain.
And you don't take it in vain. Because vain means worthless, fruitless, good for nothing. So you know what? Come down and hear the gospel preach. You know, nice simple city, because we're just a simple thing. You take it in vain.
For I delivered unto you first of all which I also received.
So we deliver what we received first of all.
How? That Yahshua died for our sins.
Well, we can't even have a detail now how Yahshua died, but we have the argument that can. How Yahshua died for our sins.
According to the scriptures.
According to the law and the prophets.
And that he was buried.
And that he was buried.
And that he rose again the third day according to the scriptures.
And that he rose again. No, that's one of that's a million dollar thing we have come back to find. Oh, he rose again. So if he rose again, You died before. You have to come back to explain now on the field. When died before. You understand? Even the ministry. I asked for him to. I've come out of traffic and said, I'll be in today. Now, give me Pentecost. Acts 1 1.
Acts.
And Colossians.
Acts. Chapter 2. Mm-hmm. Verse 1.
He said, near Yahweh, that's strong tower, you know. But and the righteous running in it, and he's safe. So you want to run in Yahweh and be safe.
Yeah. When the day of Pentecost mm-hmm. was fully come.
So when the day of Pentecost was fully come, because Pentecost was coming to come. Mm-hmm. When it fully come,
they were all with one accord in one place.
One accord, I mean, they were, if you're really one accord, you're supposed to say, let's see, that shall die, that shall be buried, and you shall rose again, the term you can't, the scriptures. Read.
And suddenly,
yeah?
There came a sound from heaven, as of a rushing mighty wind.
Rushing mighty wind.
And it filled all the house with light.
Filled up all the house. So you are moving out. You see, it's a great business.
And there appeared unto them cloven tongues, like as a fire that sat or rested mm-hmm. upon each of them. Really? And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit.
So they are filled with the assurance of
and began to speak with other tongues.
And began to declare the gospel of the kingdom.
As the
oh, Yahshua died. Oh, Yahshua was buried. Oh, Yahshua rose again the third day. Oh, Yahshua sent to the Father and poured the gift of the Holy Spirit and the Pentecost. You understand?
As the Spirit gave them utterance.
And Yahshua gave them utterance. And he's the one who gave them utterance. Colossians
1:26. Even the mystery which hath been hid from ages and from generations.
Not this was hidden from ages and generations.
But is now made manifest to his sons.
But is now made manifest to you.
To whom Yahweh would make known what is the riches of the glory of this mystery among the nations.
So Yahweh making it known unto you.
Which is Yahshua the Messiah in you.
So you see where Yahshua supposed to be? In you. And Yahshua outside is not good. You have got to know that Yahshua resurrect in your heart and in your mind. Or in your soul.
The only hope of glory.
Your only hope of glorification.
Whom we preach.
So we preach yes for resurrection.
Warning every man.
We're warning you, be clear for what you need.
And teaching every man in all wisdom.
We're teaching every man in all wisdom now.
That we may present every man perfect in
Yahshua. So Yahshua is preventing the soul perfect in himself. So Yahshua is the one washing those soul. He's the one building soul. Yahshua is the builder of soul. So brethren, we just continue giving thanks and praise. For this glorious teaching. Our praise going to Yahweh.
When I'm coming to you, I'm sorry, I get more spiritual. Are there any questions? Are there any announcements? Okay. When I'm coming to you, I'm sorry, I get more spiritual. On behalf of the Spanish, I get more. Thank you all for coming out to study us and hope you continue to come. We do classes here at the corner of Young and Eddy Street every Sunday from 4 to 6 p.m. and every Tuesday and Thursday night from 7:30 until 9. At 94 B Road Road in Kingston, we have their classes every Sunday from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m., every Wednesday from 6 to 8 p.m. and every Friday from 6 to 8:30 p.m. Please stand for an excellent. Oh, there's a person in the chat.
Yeah,
man. Okay, could you please tell us your name?
Gerard. Ted.
Okay. On behalf of the Spanish IDMR, thank you for coming out to study with us and hope you continue. Now unto him who is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise Elohim, Yahshua the Messiah, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both before and forevermore, we all say.
Amen. Amen. Amen.